Welcome to this new video where we will solve the symmetric tree problem. We have a binary tree and we want to see if it's symmetric, in other words, if it's a mirror of itself. For example, this tree is symmetric because if we take its left part, we reverse it, we get its right part. And vice versa, if we take its right part, we reverse it, we get its left part. But this one is not symmetric. For example, if we reverse its left part, we don't get the right part. Okay, how to solve this problem? To check if a tree is symmetric, what we really need to check is that left and right subtrees are symmetric to each other. We will focus on that. You need to know that for tree problems, the solution is usually done recursively. We process the root, then we call the function on both subtrees and we combine the results. For example, to get the sum of elements of a binary tree, we have the value of the root, then we recursively call the function on both subtrees to get the sum of their elements. After doing so, we return root value plus sum of left subtree plus sum of right subtree. This way of traversing is called depth first search, and it's how we solve the majority of tree problems. Let's go back to our problem. We have two trees, root 1 and root 2, and we want to check if they're symmetric to each other. First case, both trees are empty. In that case, we return true because they're still symmetric to each other. There is nothing that breaks the condition. Second case, one tree exists but the other one doesn't. In that case, we directly deduce that they're not symmetric, because the node of the tree that exists doesn't even exist in the other one. It's empty. We return false. Third case, both trees exist, but their roots don't have the same value. Here also, they're not symmetric, because in symmetric trees, the roots must have the same value, because when we reverse a tree, the root position doesn't change. And last case, both trees exist and they have the same root value. In this case, we still can't say that they're symmetric, because, okay, the roots have the same value, but we still need to check their subtrees. Having the same root value is not enough to say that they're symmetric. And if we take two symmetric trees, we can notice that they have the same root value, that the left subtree of the first one is symmetric to the right subtree of the second one, and that the right subtree of the first one is symmetric to the left subtree of the second one. We verify that roots values are equal, so we need to check the remaining two conditions. And how are we gonna do so? We're gonna do so recursively. Because if you think about it, we're building a function that checks if two binary trees are symmetric, which is exactly what we need. This is why we will use the same function. It may sound hard to understand, but this is what recursion is about, a function calling itself. If you're not familiar with recursion, you should really have a look at it. If you want to learn recursion, you can check the course I made on the subject. It's a complete course that will let you be comfortable with recursion. Let's go back to our problem. We said that we use the function we're making. We call it on root1.left and root2.right, we call it on root1.right and root2.left, and we check that both calls return true. It means that both conditions are verified, that the left subtree of root 1 is symmetric to the right subtree of root 2, and that the right subtree of root 1 is symmetric to the left subtree of root 2. Let's quickly see an example. We want to check if this tree is symmetric. So we check if its subtrees are symmetric to each other. They have the same root value, so we check left subtree of root 1 with right subtree of root 2. Same root value, we check left subtree of root 1 with right subtree of root 2. Same root value, we check left and right. Same root value, and their children are both null. They will return true. Same root value and symmetric children, all conditions are respected, it returns true. Now right subtree of root 1 with left subtree of root 2, they have the same root value. Their children are both null, both calls return true. All conditions are respected, the call returns true. Back to here, all conditions are respected, the call returns true. Now right subtree of root 1 with left subtree of root 2. they don't have the same root value, the call returns false. Not all conditions are respected, the call returns false. We don't even need to check the second call because we already have a non-respected condition, the call returns false. The initial call returned false, so our tree is not symmetric. In code, let's first make our asymmetric function. It takes two trees as parameter, root 1 and root 2. First case, both don't exist, we directly return true. Second case, one of them exists but the other one doesn't. And third case, they have a different root value. In both of these cases, the trees are not symmetric, so we return false. If root 1 is none is not equal to root 2 is none, or root 1.val is not equal to root 2.val, we return false. And now in the last case, both trees exist and have the same root value, we still need to check subtrees. We check that root 1.left is symmetric to root 2.right, and that root 1.right is symmetric to root 2.left. We do so by recursively calling the function twice, once with root 1.left and root 2.right, and once with root 1.right and root 2.left. Both of them need to return true, so we return their results combined with the AND operator. And now when our main solution function is symmetric, we first check that the input tree exists, because if it doesn't, we can directly return true, an empty tree is symmetric. Else, we check that its subtrees are symmetric to each other with the function we made now. We return asymmetric root.left root.right. That's it. For the time complexity, we're just performing a depth first search traversal of the input tree, and DFS costs O of n time where n is the number of nodes. And for the space complexity, a symmetric tree has to be balanced, and the call stack size needed by a recursive function that traverses a balanced binary tree is an O of log n. We get an O of log n space complexity. That's it for this lecture, we've seen an interesting problem on trees. I hope that you understood the solution, and see you in the next one.